Good evening, everybody. It's good to see all of you. Merry Christmas. I want to welcome all of you to Chill Alley Christian Church. I'm Frank Branson, the preacher here. And don't panic, I'm not preaching tonight. Okay? No. So anyway, we're glad that you're here. And I hope that all of us will turn our thoughts toward Jesus during the service, and especially the rest of the night and tomorrow. So, if you would bow with me for a prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you loved us enough to send your Son Jesus to earth to pay our sin debt. And we thank you that at this time of year we can celebrate his birth. And so I ask that you guide us. May our worship be acceptable to you tonight. And I pray that we would be made aware of your presence among us, and that it would enthuse us and cause us to serve you in a greater way. For we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored, the Lord is with you."
Baby, I suppose, ever know.
This is how the birth of Jesus the Messiah came about. His mother, Mary, was pledged to be married to Joseph. But before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law, and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quickly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet: "The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel," which means God with us. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him, and he took Mary home as his wife.
And I'd like to share as we light the last candle. She wrote, "Last night, Stella, the youngest, loudest, and most dynamic person in our family, sat mesmerized by the candle flame. It lit a soft, warm circle around her face and hands, slowly bowing back and forth. She stared in a rare moment of silence, and then she smiled and said, 'Look,' as wonder drenched and wise, 'it's reaching for me. The light is trying to reach me.' Tonight, as we light the last candle in the Advent wreath, the light is reaching for you. The light of the world has come to earth and is trying to reach you, extending hope, love, joy, and peace. Will you experience the miracle? Will you receive God's gift, His one and only Son, born to set you free? Will you give your heart to Him this Christmas in worship and in wonder?"
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. And this was the first census that took place while Quirinius was the governor of Syria. And everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, a town of David. because he belonged to the house and the lineage of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. And while they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. And she wrapped him in clothes, placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. presentation today, I put together sort of a Christmas poem that is a mashup of a variety of Christmas songs. It's called The Savior, The Angels, The Universe. One wintry night, the starry universe went whirling upside down, and everything that was not the same. One wintry night, a supernatural birth left heaven and earth spellbound as the mysterious omniscient took a name. Darkness fled from light. Wrong was made right in just one wintry night. The angel Gabriel from heaven came, his wings as drifted snow, his eyes as flames. All hail, said he, thou lowly Mary, for now a blessed mother thou shalt be. Thy son shall be Emmanuel for all to see, most highly favored, chosen, maiden Mary. The gentle Mary meekly bowed her head. Be as it pleases God, she said. Just a simple maiden with her hand stretched out to God, saying, Lord, thy will be done, I will abide. Just a simple stable, looking back, it does seem odd that God himself would enter there inside. Just a simple carpenter who found himself in love with a girl bearing the child of the divine. Just a simple manger. Yet somehow it was enough to accommodate the God of space and time. Don't you know the angels were breathless as he stepped down off his throne? Don't you know the darkness protested as its reign was overthrown? O holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. The thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, O hear the angel voices. O night divine, O night when Christ was born. O night, O holy night, silent night. All is calm, all is bright. Round yon virgin mother and child, the holy infant so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace. Sleep in heavenly peace. Silent night, holy night, shepherds quake at the sight. Glory stream from heaven above, heavenly hosts sing Alleluia. Christ the Savior is born. Sing glory unto God on high, joy to all the world this night, and to all people peace. Joy to the world, the Lord has come, let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing. Yes, the angels were rejoicing as the tiny baby cried, for the hope of man's salvation in a manger had arrived. Meek as a lowly shepherd, but the mightiest of kings, he gives peace and life eternal to whosoever calls his name. O Emmanuel, the Father's precious Son, who forgives our sin and washes clean the hearts of every one. One wintry night, the starry universe went whirling upside down, and everything that was not the same. One wintry night, a supernatural birth left heaven and earth spellbound as the mysterious omniscient took a name. Darkness fled from light. Wrong was made right in just one wintry night. Let us pray.
Dear God, we thank you for this time that we can come together to celebrate not only the birth of your son, but especially at this time, the death of your son. Dear God, we come asking for forgiveness of our sins tonight, and all the bad things and the ways that we have fell short of your glory just today. Dear God, we ask by the name of Jesus and by his blood that you would forgive us of our sins tonight. Help us reflect tonight, dear God, on your omnipotence, your omnipresence, your omniscience. Your omnibenevolence, your providence, and your sovereignty. All the big words, dear God, to describe how undescribable you are and how unfathomable you are. And God, as we search and try to wrap our minds around salvation, may we just reflect on how little we know and how great you must be. May we, as David, as he looked at the stars and all that you created, reflect and rejoice in our hearts and wonder why you would think of us and consider us. Dear God, we thank you for sending your Son, Jesus, to be born just to die for our sins. We celebrate not only his birth, but his eternality this morning, the eternal Godhead. And we thank you again, dear God, for loving us so much that you would send your Son just to die. We ask that you help us as we go forth from here to reflect on, not just tonight and tomorrow, but all the year, on what a great sacrifice. And although we may not understand it, God, we have a great hope, a great faith in such a great salvation. We thank you for it tonight. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you.
Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born king of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all of Jerusalem with him. When he called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are by no means least among the rulers of Judea. For out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod called all the wise men secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him." After they heard the king, they went on their way, and the star that they had seen, when it rose, went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route.
What are we to do with this good news of his birth? Like the shepherds, we fall and worship before him. Like the wise men, we bring what is most precious to us, even our very lives, and lay them down in surrender. And then we go out to make this news known to everyone. It's Christmas, and Jesus has come.
Go, tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go, tell it on the mountain, that Jesus Christ is the one. Thank you. Jesus, will one day come again. Jesus Christ is Lord. Heaven on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Heaven on the mountain, that Jesus Christ is Lord. Jesus is Lord.
Thank you.
sin, who knew no sin, that we might become His righteousness. He humbled Himself and carried the cross. Love so amazing. Love so amazing.
Can we put some of that in the monitor?
Jesus Messiah, name above all names, blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel, the rescue for sinners, the ransom. Jesus Messiah, Lord of all. His blood the bread, His blood the wine, broken and poured out all for love. The whole earth trembled and the veil was torn. Love so amazing. Love so amazing. Jesus Messiah, name above all.
Demands on us. Our lives are so full. There's so much that we have to do. But in all of our busy activities, are we in danger of excluding from our hearts and lives the one who made us? We light the center candle. It's the Christ candle. Jesus is born. Jesus has come. Jesus is our salvation. This candle lighting service is a time of renewal of faith and commitment. Each person signifies the accepting of the cleansing and renewing power of the Lord Jesus Christ by receiving the flicker of the lighted candle. This is a time of pledging loyalty to the giver of all good gifts. It's a time to invite the Christ child to let his light shine in our hearts and in our souls.
There is a candle in every soul, some brightly burning, some dark and cold. There is a spirit who brings a fire, ignites a candle, and makes it small. Carry your darkness, seek out the hopeless, confused and torn. Hold out your candle for all to see it. Take your candle, go light your world. Take your candle, go light your world. Oh.
Precious holy name. Amen. Amen.